ओके
नाउ
एज आई सेड अर्लियर So there is some disturbance. Yes. Now, as I said earlier, supply chain management is a soft core paper. And before we start up with anything else, please do remember the name of the subject and the code number of the subject. It is MBAS 457 Supply Chain Management. Now, speaking about the syllabus, you have 8 different chapters, each of that connected to one another. Now, having studied this particular paper, you should be able to know what is supply chain management. What do you mean by value chain management? How all these concepts would help you in marketing? So you do have a paper marketing management. Now having studied supply chain management, it should be helpful for you all to understand marketing management even better. It should make you understand and you know be able to remember marketing management easily. Now, supply chain management, as you can see in the syllabus itself, it is a very, very good paper and a simple one where a lot of scope is given to you as individuals to present your ideas. Now, if at all you are a very active listener when we discuss all the topics, that would be more than anything else for you all to attempt this paper. But then you are always suggested to go through textbook so that it would be helpful for you all in knowing much more information. Now speaking about the chapter 1, it is Introduction to Supply Chain Management. Here basically what we would be seeing is that we would be looking towards the meaning of supply chain management. We should try to understand why is it important, and we shall be seeing the supply chain management process and some of the important issues that are there. And moving towards the second chapter, now here you shall try to differentiate between, you know, customer relationship management and supply chain management, and more focus would be given for outsourcing. Oh, so what is this outsourcing? Why is it important for us to understand outsourcing concept when it comes to supply chain management? And also we shall be speaking about value addition and the demand of the supply chain management. Now speaking about the third chapter, here we shall be speaking all about logistic management. Now, logistic management is yet another dimension of your marketing management. So, we shall see how logistics is also part of supply chain management. Logistics are nothing but transportation. How transportation is important. Now, all these concepts or ideas, if you closely observe, are such that right now if I ask you something, you shall be able to put it down in your paper. Now, the fourth chapter is regarding the recent trends that are happening in the supply chain management. Now, supply chain management, now it's present from the time when business used to be there. But what are the changes that are happening now? How is it being seen in different areas? What are the additional qualities of supply chain management in the recent days? And how will supply chain happen all around the globe is something we shall understand in Chapter 4. Now, Chapter 5 is all regarding supply chain benchmarking. Now, this chapter speaks about how to make your supply chain the best compared to the others. Now, Chapter 6 speaks about coordination in the supply chain. Now, this is because supply chain is not something wherein only two or three of the parties are involved. Now, supply chain is something wherein there are a lot of people, there is lot of different parties involved, each party with the aim of benefiting themselves. And when say a case is such, now here comes the question of coordination. Now, for a supply chain to be the best, there will have to be coordination within the supply chain. And in discussing that, definitely with coordination, if we are speaking of coordination, it definitely puts light on the fact that there shall definitely be some of the obstacles. Now, when you resolve the obstacles, that is when you have a good coordination. So, in meeting all these things, what are the strategies that we have to use? What are the internal supply chain management within the organization that would be having? How to manage the relation with the supplier or the outsider other than the firm? All these things we shall discuss in Chapter 6. Now, Chapter 7 especially speaks about the information technology and how information technology has changed the way of supply chain management in the recent trends. Can the supply chain along with logistic information system? And the last chapter is with regarding global supply chain management. Now, this chapter is from that point of view that unless like our earlier business activities which used to be done maybe before 30-40 years, we could politically discriminate, you know, nations on the basis of the boundaries that we have. But then if you see the business how it is being done today, now it is a boundaryless business. That is to tell, you sitting here, you can order a product or service from your supplier from any corner of the world, provided you are willing to buy and able to pay for it. So when such is the case, how the supply chain management shall happen? And what is the main difference between the domestic supply chain and global change management? And the trends in the global supply chain management? So all this we shall discuss under Chapter 8. So this is all about your syllabus of supply chain management. Now you might have got an idea. Now I have also taken your modern organization and management. Now if I compare modern organization and management and your supply chain management, what you had studied in your first two chapter of your modern organization and management, now here the entire 8 chapters would be covered up in so much of notes if I tell. If you make one, so that is how comparison could be. But then understanding supply chain management, especially from the point of view of you tomorrow being a marketing manager, or you being a chief executive of a company, or the best case, you being an entrepreneur, is a very good choice that you have made. Because no matter how much good product you produce, how much good service you are able to give to your customer, ultimately the question comes down to the fact, how well can you distribute your product? It is not enough that you produce and keep it in your warehouse. Will it move towards your ultimate consumer is the question that you should be able to answer. Because your revenue are the one thing that is important for your company comes from the ultimate consumer who is going to use your product or your service. So reaching them is one of the important aspects when we speak about the reality of the business. So we in modern organization, we spoke all about coordination, the employees, the company, organization. Yes, that is necessary. But who gives you the revenue for doing all these things are no one but your customer. So how will you be able to reach them is the question asked here. And all the difficulties that are present would be removed by the time you would be able to answer that question in a good way. So I hope this will be an interesting subject. Given the fact that your coordination is there, you people also do mingle in the discussion. Now, what has been put up in your slide is the reference of the textbook that have been given in your syllabus. Now, I shall definitely try to, collect all these books, the e-books if possible, and if I do get, I shall be sharing it with you all. Even you can search, if you get this textbook, you can definitely share in your WhatsApp group so that you and your classmates can refer it. Now, except for this book, there are some of the textbooks that I already have. Maybe I shall share it with you all so that you can refer them. Now with the notes, I expect you all to maintain one, not for my sake, but for the sake that it shall be helpful for you all. Having said that, so now I would like to know your opinion. What do you think? How might this subject to be? An interesting one or a boring one?
Interesting one.
It has to be interesting. And one more thing. Welcome back to this session of supply chain management. So shall we start with our first chapter, students? Okay. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then we shall continue with chapter 1. Now, Chapter 1 is with regards to introduction to supply chain management. Now, you in your last session, some of you said your idea about supply chain. Now, if you see, all your ideas are correct, but the thing is, now each one of you said some little parts of the entire supply chain management. So we shall see in detail what this supply chain management is. One more thing, if at all I am being fast and you have to take down notes and you were unable to take it down, do let me know. But now when I share the slides, please see to that you unmute yourself and tell, because I would be unable to see the chat box. Now, speaking about supply chain management, now the supply chain management, we can define it as the management of flow of products. Now, when I tell products, it means both goods and services are included in that. Okay, now it is flow of products and services which begins from the origin of the product and ends at the product's consumption. So if half the product or half this goods and service moves from the place where it origins to the ultimate place of its consumption is nothing but the supply chain. And how will we manage it, or what are the things that we use to manage it, is nothing but supply chain management. Okay. Now, having said that, we can observe that this supply chain, it also includes, it also comprises the movement of goods and storage of raw materials, and the movement of raw materials that are involved in the work in progress, inventory, and also fully furnished goods. Now, these are the some of the words. No matter you haven't seen in other subject, you would have definitely seen in your accounts. Maybe the work in progress, what is inventory, what is your finished goods. Now all these are three different stage of your products. If you see, some are in, you know, they are being converted from raw materials to finished goods. They are in the way of that particular process, that is work in progress. You have inventory, then you have the fully furnished goods. So, this is one of the simple meaning of the supply chain management, where we can define supply chain as the management of flow of products and services, which begins from the origin of products and ends at the products consumption. And also it comprises movement and storage of raw materials that are involved in work in progress, inventory, and fully furnished goods. Now, do not concentrate on your, do not concentrate on the slide. Just look into the picture that you have, you can see. So, this particular picture speaks about what a supply chain management is all about. So, in this particular picture, we can see flow of goods, services, and also information. Now, flow of goods, they have mentioned it as product. Flow of services, they have mentioned it as financial. I mean, flow of product is both for your goods and services, and information you have, and you have finance over there. So this particular picture, it depicts the movement of product from the producer to the manufacturer and who forwards it to the distributor for shipment. Now the distributor in turn ships it to the wholesaler or retailer who further distributes the products to various shops from the customers and can easily get the product. Okay, so this is one simple picture how you can draw supply chain management. First, you'll be having supplier. Supplier is the person who would be giving all the inputs that are necessary for the manufacturer either to produce a product or to produce some services. Okay, and the manufacturer, once after the production, sends it to the distribution center. So from there it shall be moved on to the retailer or wholesaler if you need. From distributor it usually goes to wholesaler, wholesaler to retailer, retailer to ultimate shops from where consumers can get it easily. And along with the, in this chain, your product moves, your information goes, and your finances. And with this product, with this information and finances and products, it is always a two-way process. Now, this is one basic supply chain management. So consider a fact that nowadays all that is happening in the way of e-commerce. Now taking that into consideration, how might things move? Whether nowadays wholesalers and retailers are given importance, or is it that companies are directly, you know, having their relations with the consumer? What is happening? We can speak about all this. We can speak about large outlets, like things might be how your JioMart or your more outlets work out. With each, the supply chain how we depict would definitely change. And one more thing, see to that whenever you try to explain, try giving example, simple example which can speak about the concept in an easier way. Now, having said that, the supply chain management, it basically merges the supply and also the demand management. Now it uses different strategies and approaches to view the entire chain and work efficiently at each and every step involved in the chain. So every unit that participates in the process must aim to minimize the cost and help the companies to improve their long-term performance while also creating value for its stakeholders and consumers. So this process can also minimize the rates by eradicating the unnecessary expenses, movements, and also handling. Okay, I guess there is a lot of network issue today. I'm sorry, there is a lot of network issue, but then I hope you are managing it. Please do let me know if you are unable to hear me. Okay?
ओके
Okay. Now, see to this. Okay, now this particular picture that has been put up itself, it speaks about what are the things that are included in supply chain management. Now definitely it includes the procurement of the raw materials in the first thing. Once you procure, you should be able to manage things. Once it is done, you would be having product in your hand. With the product, you distribute, and along the way, you will have to plan, you'll have to think of the profit. Then you have when is the actual time to market your goods, and there comes the analysis of all the situation that you have to go through, and importantly, your logistics also plays an important role here. So these are some of the elements that are included in the supply chain. Now, what does this supply chain actually does? So supply chain management, it tries to maximize profit. Now, that is the one thing why a business has been set up, isn't it? So the supply chain management, it maximizes profit. But how? Now, it maximizes profits by integrating three key flows across the boundaries of the company. So it tells that there is three important aspects in the supply chain management. So these three main aspects, the supply chain tries to bring it together, and thereby it sees to that there shall be maximization of profit. So, if there are three things, what are these three? Yeah. So, these three are flow of values. The first one is flow of value. The second one is flow of information. And third one is flow of fund. Now, whenever I tell flow of value, it means it is the product or the materials or the service. So the three things are product, information, and fund. So successful integration and coordination of these three flows of produces improved efficiency and effectiveness for business organization. Now, speaking about this supply chain, in theoretical terms, supply chain can work as cohesive or what we can tell, singularly competitive units, which are similar to vertically integrated firm without any kind of significant financial investment by the members of the chain. But the basic difference between vertically integrated firms and that of a supply chain is that firms in supply chains are relatively free to enter and leave supply chain relations if these relationships are no longer proving beneficial to the organization. So this is one of the main challenges of supply chain management, where you know the members of the supply chain, you do not know whether they are going to stay tomorrow or whether they are no longer in this process. So maintaining relationships and having a coordination between all the members is one of the important aspects of supply chain. So this supply chain, they are often very dynamic, or one more word what we can give us, it is fluid in nature. That is, partners can change. Each partner within the supply chain or each member within the supply chain, they will look for their long-term advantage, and this sometimes also causes problems in, you know, effectively managing supply chains. While supply chain management may allow organizations to realize the advantage of vertical integration, now certain conditions must be present for successful supply chain management to occur. Now, like any other business, even this supply chain, it creates competition among supply chains and also supply chain partners. Therefore, supply chains can operate more effectively than many vertically integrated conglomerates. So now this was just the introduction. Now, while discussing, we spoke about three different aspects, that is flow of information, flow of value, where we spoke about product and materials, and we spoke about flow of funds. Now see, look into the slide, see into the picture. This is how, if we have to draw a line diagram of a supply chain, this is how it is. Now you have different suppliers. Now suppliers are the ones who would be giving the raw materials to each of the manufacturing plants. There are three different manufacturing plants in this particular diagram. Now each of the manufacturing plants, it produces either half finished goods or sometimes raw materials for some other product to be produced. Once after that is done, everything shall be sent into manufacturing headquarters. Now there would be finished goods from manufacturing headquarters for sales headquarters, and also some things which might be directly sent. Okay, and once after that, the distribution happens. It can be branch, from branch to store, store to ultimate customer, or it can also be the wholesaler, wholesaler to retailer, retail to ultimate customer. One thing that you can see here is that the supplier and the manufacturer, they make the supply part of the supply chain management, and the branches, stores and customer, they make the demand side of the supply chain. And with the manufacturer and supplier, they are concerned with the manufacturing of goods and services. When it comes for the branches, store and customer, they are concerned with the distribution of this products or services. Now, speaking about the concept of supply chain management, this particular discipline, this particular knowledge, it has been built on procurement management, it has been built on operation management, and also logistics foundation. But then, supply chain management, it tends to exceed these traditional concepts. So, supply chain management is involved with integrating three key flows, that is, flow of information, products and materials, and funds, with, you know, between different stages across the boundaries of the components. And we were speaking about this members of supply chain, or the parties involved. Now, they can also be called as partners. So, these members of the supply chain, they act as partners and are linked together throughout both physical movement of goods or service and also the information flow. So, it is this that makes an effective supply chain. The flows that involve the information, movement, storage of goods and materials and money are called physical flows. So, these flows are easily, you know, visible. So, how the way in which the product moves from, as we said, supplier to manufacturer and so on and so to ultimate consumer, that is very much physically observable. You can see it passing down from one particular party to the other. So, this particular physical flow of products or service, now it is reinforced by information flows. Okay? Now, information flows regarding what? Maybe, how can this product be made better, whether there is demand for the product, or what is it, the other things that the customer wants to have. All these are information. Okay? Now, information flows are used by the various supply chain partners to coordinate their long-term plans, as well as it also helps to efficiently control the day-to-day flow of goods and materials to the supply chain. Now, if we observe clearly, in reality, the supply chain, it enables not only the flow of product and services and information from one direction, but it goes both up and down the chain. So, successful integration or coordination of these three flow of producers and improved efficiency and effectiveness for business organization. So, having discussed so much about supply chain management, we can define it as the active management of supply chain activities to maximize customer value and achieve a sustainable competitive advantage. What is this now? Sustainable competitive advantage. So it is the integration of two words, if you see, that is sustainability and competitive advantage. Now, sustainability is that act wherein which you try to become more and more better than you are. But it has to be better every time without compromising something or anything that belongs to the future. That is sustainability. Competitive advantages, that particular feature which gives you a benefit or which gives you an edge over your competitors, or it would be that one particular point which your competitors would be unable to reach. That is called as competitive edge. So, this supply chain management, it represents a conscious effort by the supply chain firm to develop and also to run supply chain in the most effective and efficient way possible. There can be various types of supply chain. So, there is a basic supply chain and an extended supply chain. The definition of basic supply chain is a set of three or more companies directly linked by one or more of the upstream or downstream flow of production, services, finance, and information from a source to a customer. That is to tell what we saw in the earlier slide, where we saw how from supplier the manufacturer gets it, manufacturer sends it to the retailer. Wholesaler to retailer and to shops, and along the chain there is flow of products, information and finance. So that is basic supply chain. When we speak about extended supply chain, it shall include suppliers of the immediate supplier and customer of the immediate customer. So this is extended supply chain, where there is supplier. He has his suppliers and there is supplier also on the left side of the diagram. If you see in the right side, you have distributors, distributor to wholesaler, wholesaler to retailer. And with this information flows, the fund flow and the material flow. This is the extended supply chain, how it works. So, we shall take into consideration so this is traditional supply chain relationship, the A, from seller to buyer the things would move, that is traditional supplier buyer relationship. And before maybe 10-20 years we had this basic supply chain, where you have supplier, the one who sells, and the buyer. Now this particular diagram, it has been taken from Exploring the Supply Chain book that has been written by Upendra Kachur in the year 2010. So now, as you can see, it is, so this particular diagram, this shows an extended supply chain, which consists of, as you can see, numeral number of relationship. Now these are also called as tiers, the first tier supplier, the second tier supplier. Okay, or nothing but the stages, what you can say. Now, for the product to reach a typical customer who goes to the shop to buy beer, these linkages and the steps necessary to bring the product to him are not probably apparent here. Okay, so now I'll explain you what this is all about. Now this is the supply chain of, or a simplified supply chain of, one of the firm called as Kalyani Breweries company. Now why is this a extended supply chain? Now this NALCO, okay, it is the National Aluminium Company. NALCO represents National Aluminium Company. This company extracts the aluminium ore and converts it into aluminium metal. Okay? Now that aluminium metal is sent to, or it is shipped to Supertech Industries, and we shall, you know, and this Supertech Industries, it is situated in Bangalore. Now the Supertech Industries, they convert the aluminium into cans. Okay. Now Supertech Industries supplies cans to Kalyani Breweries. So as Supertech Industries supplies directly to Kalyani Breweries, it is the first tire supplier in the chain. Now using the same logic, Norco is the second supplier. It is nothing but supplier of supplier for Kalyani Breweries. Now would you, can you make out the first tire supplier and second tire supplier? Kalyani Breweries is the company. They are into the production of producing beer. Okay. Now, for this company, Supertech Industries are the ones which provide the aluminium cans. So the deal is between Supertech Industries and Kalyani Breweries. So for Kalyani Breweries, Supertech Industry, they become the first tire supplier. There is a direct link. Now when you compare National Aluminium Company and Kalyani Breweries, there is no direct connection. But then whatever product they'll have to get from Supertech Industries, it shall be provided to the Supertech Industries from the National Aluminium Company. Therefore, National Aluminium Company becomes the second tire supplier of Kalyani Breweries, or in simple words, they are the supplier of suppliers for Kalyani Breweries. Now, this company is into the production of beer. So the beer is produced from other raw materials such as, you know, barley, hops, yeast and water. Aluminium cans from Supertech Industries used to contain the product and combined with cartons to produce the packaged beverage. So Kalyani Breweries then sells the packed beverage to UBSN Limited. Who is the distributor? Now who in turn sells the finished goods to the retailers, and the retailer's name that they have given as TSIDC. So transportation carriers move the inputs and outputs from one place to the next along the supply chain, provides the logistic support. So with this example, we can see that goods and information flow travels both ways. Or in other words, members in the supply chain are both customers and suppliers with respect to these flow of goods. Now, if you want me to explain this particular example once again, I can do it in a very simple way. Now, the company that we have taken is Kalyani Breweries. Now, we shall see the extended supply chain of this particular company. Now, this Kalyani Breweries, they are into producing the beer or this beer beverage. Now, the thing is that they will be having their supplier. Once after producing the goods, they'll have to distribute. They have their distributor. Now, for this company to produce beer, they'll have to produce the beer. They need a can to sell it and all the other things with the can. Whatever has to be labeled, the package, how it goes, everything. Now, the Supertech industry is one such company which is a supplier of the cans for the beers to be put in and sold. Now, Supplier Tech Industries provides Kalyani Breweries with the bottles that are intended to fill the beer. Now, since Supertech Industry has direct connection with the Kalyani Breweries, Supertech Industry are the first tier suppliers for the company. But Supertech Industries to produce the aluminium can, they need aluminium. The aluminium, or they would be taking it from National Aluminium Company. So, for Kalyani Breweries, National Aluminium Company shall be supplier of supplier and they become second tier supplier. So once they have can, once they have produced the beer using all other raw materials, they would fill up the can and once the goods is produced, they would send it to the distributor. Distributor, they have given the name as UBSL Limited. Now distributor sells it to the retailer and the retailer would be selling it to the final customer. Now, who makes this particular thing happen is the logistics. Logistics, or in other words, the transportation companies who shall be moving the product from the place of its origin to the place of its consumption. One more thing that we can see along in the supply chain is management is that some parties involved or the parties involved, they shall first thing that they do is they shall help in sending or passing the information, passing the flow of goods from both the direction, from the upward direction to the ultimate consumer, from the consumer to all the way up to the supplier. Second thing is each party involved becomes customer to the one, supplier to the other. That is, Supertech Industry is a customer of National Aluminium Company, whereas Supertech Industries acts as a supplier to Kalyani Breweries. The same with the Kalyani Breweries. Kalyani Breweries, they are the customers of Supertech Industries, whereas they are suppliers to UBSL Limited. So that is how supply chain works. Now, one more thing that we have to see in supply chain is that for any supply chain, it could be the simple one, the extended one, the basic one, okay? For any supply chain, there is only one source of revenue, that is the customers. So here, if we take this particular slide that has been mentioned, now, individual who comes to DSIDC or the retailer. So a customer purchasing beer is the only one providing positive cash flow for the supply chain. All other cash flows are simply fund exchanges that occur within the supply chain, given that different stages have different owners. So when DSIDC pays its supplier, it is taking a portion of the funds the customer provides and passing that money on to the supplier. So it is all these flows, that is information, products or funds, that generates the cost within the supply chain. Now, this is a simple design, but if we dig deep, the appropriate design of the supply chain will depend on both the customer's need and the role of stages involved. So this relationship reflects a single strand in the supply chain in a typical supply chain. Therefore, there are many more participants than one. That is, Kalyani Breweries has hundreds of suppliers who provide barley or the yeast or the cartons that are to be sticked into the bottle. And it also has a larger extent network of retailers throughout the countries whose number is even higher. So regardless of the number and different types of suppliers a firm uses to satisfy its requirements, the overall structure and its essential interference and control process have to be identified irrespective of how vast and complex the system is. Now, one more thing that you will have to take into consideration with supply chain is that any operation or the facility which is present in one supply chain arrangement may also be a part of one or different other supply chains. So okay, before we go, so this is how the extended supply chain management works, where in which there are all kinds of people involved. Now, if at all you are further interested in knowing what is supply chain. Now, here within we have something called as, you know, a third party logistic provider. Now, such providers, they may be member of two supply chains. So, where they perform the logistic activity between companies that are, you know, conventionally competing with each other. To give an example, you know, it could be the complex relation, be the case of, you know, Reliance Communications. Now, this Reliance Communications might find Nokia to be a customer in one supply chain, a partner in another, a supplier in a third, and a competitor in still a fourth supply chain. So this multiple supply chain phenomenon also explains the complex nature of the network created by many supply chains. That is to tell, with large organizations, what happens is that they will not be having one particular supply chain. They will be having hundreds of products and hundreds of supply chains. So what happens is that in the same way there shall be one another company which is into production of 100 company, 100 more products. Now, when you consider these two large organizations, sometimes what happens is that in a particular supply chain, the two companies might be a supplier and a customer. Somewhere they could be partners. In one more another, they could act as competitor. So this is one more distinct feature of supply chain. Now, whenever you see large enterprise, like let us consider Dabur, you might have heard this name. They are into this daily products and beauty products. So they are involved in marketing, you know, a broad product line to numerous customers. It also engages itself in basic manufacturing of products and also assembling of the products. And also procurement materials and components, not only on the national basis, but on a global basis. So when that is the case, the supply chain shall be very complex. But however, for any supply chain, there is only one source of revenue, that is customer. So logically, the source of costs are all flows of information, products or funds. So, the appropriate management of these flow is the key to supply chain success. So, when you have to evaluate the success of the supply chain, the links between the manufacturer and the retailer have to function at desired level. Now, even when the performance of the earlier stages of the supply chain is outstanding, this is not important if the product is not available to support retail sales. So this is because the end customer is the only source of revenue for the supply chain, and the link is the ultimate test to the success of the supply chain. The basic objective of supply chain management is to maximize the supply chain profitability. So a more successful supply chain will therefore have higher profitability. The profitability of a supply chain is difference between what the customer pays for the final product and the cost the supply chain expends in filling the customer's request. Now, the supply chain helps in managing the inventory. The more effective your supply chain is, the less the inventory days would become. What is this inventory days? You might be knowing. Now, with the help of this supply chain and making it more effective, Hindustan Lever was able to reduce its inventory from 45 days to less than 5 days. That is, they need not have a very large warehouse where they had to, you know, keep their products for 45 days. But with the effect of supply chain, they were able to minimize the storage capacity for within less than 5 days. Now, what I shall do is, one work that you have is for yourself, it is just do it yourself. If you want, you have to do it. It is for your purpose of knowing more. First work that I said in the earlier class was, you will have to know what is this supply chain, what is this value chain, is there any kind of difference, or whether they are complement to one another, or whether they are one and the same. The second thing is, the best example What supply chain is, or the best example for the effective supply chain is understanding the how the things work at Bombay Dabbawala. Now this information is available for you all over the internet. So do go through that. It is a very very interesting case for you all to understand the supply chain management or the effectiveness of supply chain management or the first ever supply chain, if you have to say. Now I will tell in very brief 5 to 10 lines. You please go through the detailed ones of the story behind the success of Bombay Dabbawalas. Okay. Now this is a company of earlier semi-literary tiffin wallas. Okay. Now this particular company, it shows the world class supply chain. Also it shows how important it is to have coordination of information and activities from the parties who are involved. Now what happens here is that different people, they supply the tiffin, they prepare the items that are to be filled in the tiffin and is considered as the supplier in this particular supply chain context to the ones who receives the tiffin. They are the client. So this shows the trust between the tiffin wallahs and the management of the relationship. So how does this supply chain system work? Now the tiffin is filled with the lunch. Okay. Now the lunch is what they provide. So lunch at the client's kitchen or the one who has taken the order, and it shall be kept outside the client's house and it should be kept by morning 8:25 and within 8:30 a.m. And that time the tiffin wallahs arrive, they pick the tiffin and moves on. Now they shall knock the door only if the tiffin is not seen. Under normal circumstances, there is no interaction with any member of the client household. By 8:38 a.m., the tiffin is placed on the bicycle or push cart together with the tiffin collected from other customers. Now this bicycles and push carts, it is drawn by individual tiffin wallahs. They arrive from various collection centers to the suburban railway station by 9:20 a.m. Now at the station, the sorting operation begins with the tiffin sorted according to destinations and place in the cartages that are specific to each destination. So the cartages come in two standard size, accommodating 24 and 48 tiffins each. So this work is completed by 9:41 a.m. when the suburban train arrives. So the cartages, normally numbering 5 to 6, are loaded into the special compartment located next to the driver's cabin. The train arrives at one of the major hubs by 10:21. The cartages are unloaded and bundled with those arriving from other collection centers. Now they are resorted according to destinations by 11:05. The cartages are located into suburban train for onward journey to the final destination terminals. When the suburban train reaches the terminal station, cartages are unloaded and tiffins are resorted. Now according to specific delivery, by 10 p.m. the tiffins are placed in destination specific cartages and hitched typically onto bicycle or push carts for delivery to individual clients and delivered at the doorsteps of the client workshop. Now at the latest by 12:30, the delivery process is reversed in the afternoon
The empty tiffin is picked up by 1:15 p.m. and 2 p.m. for its return to the client's home early that evening by 5:30. So with this we can see that the whole operation is a marvel of product movement through coordination, trust, multitasking and role change, and perfect exchange of information through the coding system, rail timings and knowledge of Mumbai's geography. So this is a perfect supply chain. Now if you may be shocked to listen that there is something called a standard error. Now standard error is something you cannot miss out. Now when it comes to this supply chain management of Dabawalas, for every 10 lakh tiffins that they exchange, there is only one mistake that happens. So that is the amount of precision that is there in the chain. So that is how beautiful the supply chain management of this particular company is going on. So now I guess it's time, and I guess I can take down your attendance.
Dhanush ma'am.